So now that we have this design intent coming from the designer, how do we start to build a 3D object out of that without being an expert and spending 6 months of modeling with complex mathematical stuff? So this is where we use this technology called Natural Sketch. It's pretty unique on the market. We have, I think, 8 patents on that technology. It's how do you keep the sketching paradigm, way of sketching, but producing 3D objects. So here we will use a pen, and we will start to sketch. But first of all, as we are in a software that the engineering department can use also, we can open 3D data coming from engineering. For example, here we want to have a simple referential, which is the positioning of the wheels coming from the platform. And for ergonomic studies also, why not some mannequins, just to have a better understanding of the proportions, the volumes, of where we stand. So we are in the 3D world, so we are more precise because we are in the 3D world, and we will start to express our idea by sketching. So Pierre will move to a side view. So he will move to a side view, and with the Wacom tablet, with a digital pen that you will see later on, he's just sketching sketches to produce this sketch, which is in fact a 3D sketch. So I'm going on the side view, and then I'm sketching. And you can iterate multiple times. You know, creative process is about trying, removing, trying again, trying again, trying again, until you find the right shape that you like. Okay? And that's the beauty of this capturing the gesture of the pen, the artist. So at the end, you capture the precise curve that you want, respecting the early 2D sketch. And if you want to produce a 3D, the magic is that going to a top view, from a different view, you continue to sketch the same curve, the same sketch. And finally, so here is taking the sketch, continue to sketch from the top view. And finally, by sketching from different views, the software is producing a 3D sketch. So now if I turn around the sketch, you see that finally I have a complex 3D sketch in the space. So I can start to have a first understanding of my volume, of my proportions, of my character lines, by keeping the creative paradigm of sketching. So we remove the barrier of the technology, which is way too complex at the early phase of the ideation. So if Pierre, just to show you how it works, maybe in 4 views, Pierre, so you have a better understanding of what we just did. We will remove the full sketch. We just split the screen in 4 views and redo what we just did, so you have a better understanding of what we just did. So you have the top view, the side view here, and here you have a perspective view. So here I'm sketching from the side view. If you can sketch on the side view, Pierre, you will see the same sketch appearing on the top view here and on the perspective view. And if I continue to sketch on the top view, you will see that finally in the perspective, we have a 3D sketch. The goal for us is to help designers to quickly transform their 2D idea into something in 3D. So, if we go back to the one screen, we will show you now the complete 3D sketch. If you spend more time, so you can at least see the first, let's say, main character line of the car made by 3D sketching. There is another way to do that, is that if you have side views made by hand, to put that on the back of your screen, and to, like Decalco, to reproduce very precisely to respect the 2D sketches made by hand, like the one you have on the back here. You have 2 ways now to do sketching. And the idea, why we're doing that, is to start to go to the 3D world. So at any time, you can use this 3D sketch to start to produce concept surfaces. So for example, here, Pierre, we'll use this character line and some sections that he did by sketching. Well, first of all, he's using multi-touch device that you will see later on. To navigate in the space here, you can use multi-touch device. So you can manipulate with your 2 hands to turn around your objects, to really understand and see the volumes and the proportion of your model. And when you need more precision, you take back the digital pen and you can continue to sketch. We really wanted to make the user experience very intuitive and easy to use. So then, as I said, we are going to the surfaces, to generate the surface and the volume of the car. So here, Pierre will use another tool called Imagine and Shape. We will use this sketch that we made by hand, with a digital pen, to generate a surface. So we just select the different sections that we sketch to generate the primary, the first concept surfaces. So it's not manufacturable, it's not very precise, but the idea is very quickly, in a few seconds, to start to see the surfaces, the highlights, the reflections, the shadows, and quickly to start to iterate on that. Okay, here we are not doing the surfaces to manufacture the car. We are still at the very early phase of the creativity to be able to explore many design alternatives. So how can we quickly start to create surfaces? Okay, so thank you, Pierre. So can we switch back to the other computer? So now that we have done that, we need to do concept modeling. Can switch.